Well, hello there, amazing people of YouTube. I'm going to talk again. I love to talk. I really love to talk. So, why do I run Linux? Well, there's a little bit of history behind it. So, at the age between 10 and 12, I started to help people out with computers. Cleaning up Windows install, cleaning out viruses, figuring out floppy drives and IOs and all of those things. And one day I met this older guy, I think he's like my age now, like he was the age I am now at that time. And we started to talk, and we just started to talk about computers. And I was basically a dumping place for people that every time they bought a new PC, I got the old one. Or I got it for like really fucking cheap money. So I always had a lot of spare parts laying around in my room. So I always sold like a hard drive or, you know, a floppy disk or, you know, I always had our chassis or old motherboard or like a CD-ROM drive to people and stuff like that. And he was the kind of the guy that people came to when they needed like a really, really cheap computer to just do really, really basic things. So he bought a lot of these things that people were giving me or I got really, really cheap. So I made a little bit of money out of that. But I also helped him with computer problems that he had, and he kind of taught me a lot of things. And then one day I was going out of the door, and he gave me a book with Red Hat Linux on, like 4.2 or something like that, or 6, I can't remember it. And he said, like, you have Spring Break soon? Yeah? Try and install this. And that was all he told me. So I got home, and I got this paperback book about Linux, how to install Red Hat Linux, in English, and back then I knew nothing about English, and like I said, I was around between 15 and 16 or something like that. So it took me 3 or 4 days to install Linux, the Red Hat Linux, and when I got it installed, I was just, wow, this is totally new for me. It was kind of like, I love exploring. So I was like, there's so many new things I can learn. There's so many new things in this environment. So I started experimenting, and when I figured out what root was and all of that shit, and with my really, really bad English and translation from Danish to English, because the translation books we had back then in the 90s, like you could, but we didn't really have internet back then. We have dial-up internet. I could only use it for an hour. Was it every week or every second day or something like that? So I was relying on just, you know, your box standard Danish to, or English to Danish translation book, and they don't have technical English in it. It was just how do you do and stuff like that. It was not like technical English. So a lot of the technical terms and computer language that you and I talk nowadays was not there. Like, example, when I looked up root, like it starts to say root of a tree and stuff like that, and I was like, why are you talking about botany and trees and stuff like that when I'm on a computer system? It makes there's a lot of things that I don't connect it because I didn't have a technical English to Danish translation book or vocabulary, or what the fuck you would call it. That's why it took so long. So it was a lot of trial and error. And again, with a between 14 and 16 year old mind, like you were all over the place with your hormones and shit like that. So you have a lot of other things thinking about, and you're really stupid when you're a kid. Like when you get older, you realize how stupid you are as a kid. But anyway, I just discovered a whole new world, because before that my world was Windows. All my exploring and all of my tinkering and things like that, I did that under Windows. Like the first time I booted up my own Windows computer, I was looking at the system folder, and there was this explore.exe, and I'm like, that's the fucking internet browser. I don't have internet. Let's delete that. Oh, I could not boot into Windows again. Then I had to learn how to install Windows. I never done that before, so I got a copy of Windows, and I learned how to, or taught myself how to install Windows. I found that really, really fucking interesting and funny. I like that shit. I like learning that way. So when Linux trumped into my lab, there was like a whole new world of me exploring and learning and tinkering and breaking and figuring out how things worked and what they were. Going into MTAP and FTAP and all of these things, figure out what NTF file system was and EXT4 or 2 or 1, I can't remember, I think it was EXT1 back then, and Riser file systems and how the, you know, permission was done and all of that shit in config files. It was just, yes, I loved this. I could spend hours on it. And then the more I learned about Linux, the more I just liked it. I just liked it for what it was. It was it has so much greatness going forward in the way of exploration, and I could do almost what I want. Like, I could tinker with everything because everything is a file. That's the Unix philosophy. So I didn't have files I couldn't open and look at and stuff like that, like you do on the Windows. There's some files that are encrypted or decoded because of security, or they contain stuff that you can't see. You don't have that many of those under Linux, because the only the only thing that's encrypted and stuff like that are like security passwords and stuff like that. But I could go into a program and I could see the source code, or I could see, you know, the config files really, really easily. And on the CD was the source code also, so I could see, I didn't know what the fuck I was looking at, but I could download this package called VLC/source or something. I don't know if VLC was around back then, but you get my idea here, and I could see what the fuck that was. So I loved it, and that's kind of why I still use Linux to this day. It's not because I'm anti-proprietary software, or anti-government, or anti-big business, or there's no philosophical or spiritual reasons why I run Linux. It's just, still to this day, a really, really great place to explore programs, to learn, because it's evolving so fast, and there's so many new programs coming into Linux that are open for you to look at and to tinker with than there are in my experience anyway for Windows. And because I'm also like servers a lot and stuff like that, which Linux is heavily into, it just makes sense. And for me to tinker in that way, like I've tried OS2 and FreeBSD, I tried that a couple of times. I tried BOS and then Haiku and all of those. Linux is not my favorite operating system, but it's my go-to place for just exploring, tinkering. I just like that it's still to this day, that it still for me is this open canvas of learning and exploration and stuff like that. Yes, I still learn and explore on the Windows, but for the most part, I do that under Linux because you have the control to do so. Linux allow you to explore. Linux allow you to tinker and stuff like that. Basically, Linux allow you to break your system. Windows is a little bit more guarded. It's a little bit harder to do stupid shit under Windows that could break the system without it yelling and screaming at you, or just plain old don't allow you to do it. Where under Windows, if you want to peen your fucking hard drive, metaphorically, you can do that under fucking Linux, you know. You can delete explore.exe. I don't know if you can do that today. I haven't tried under Windows. Maybe I should do that. But Linux don't really say much about it. You just can't boot into your system. Where nowadays, Windows is so hand-holding you that it's fucking crazy. Which is a good thing. I get it. I know why they're doing it. And I like that they're doing it sometimes. But sometimes I just want to be free to do whatever I want. Explore and install different desktop environments, customizing environments, trying different versions of programs, and reprogramming programs or tinkering with programs that I'm using and stuff like that. That's why I use Linux. It's from a exploring mindset. It's from a tinkering mindset. It's from a curiosity mindset. And that's why I don't associate, I don't like all of these philosophical reasons why people are using it, like open source versus closed source, and anti-government, anti-business, and anti-money, and blah blah blah, because I don't associate that's not, I don't think about that. That's not why I run Linux. If I was anti-business, anti blah blah blah, I would want something that has nothing to do with business or big business, like Haiku. Because face it or not, Linux to some extent is big business. The Linux kernel is big business. It's just another business model than, let's say, Microsoft. It's still, how can we make money? How can we stay alive? How can we keep the lights on? You do that by generating money or getting money either by donation or development time and stuff like that. Maybe some make a video about that. But their end goal is to keep the lights on. And by doing that, they need money. Way more than Haiku and any other smaller OS So Linux is big business. You just have the opportunity to run distribution made out of Linux that are not big business, but they're utilizing work that's done by big business people. So you are kind of supporting big business anyway. But again, that's just not a philosophy that I'm into. I'm more like, this is fun. I want Linux for fun, basically. That's it. It's fun and interesting. And yes, in the early 2000s, I also ran Linux because it was fucking way more stable than Windows. I would say the late 90s, I ran Linux as my main system because we had Windows ME that crashes all the fucking time. Then I ran Windows 2000 for a little while, which was an amazing system. Windows XP in the beginning was a little bit iffy, but when Service Pack 1 or 2 came out, I think it was Service Pack 2, they were like, Windows XP was just spot on. And that was the only time I ran Linux between like ME and up to XP Service Pack 1 or 2, where I ran Linux because it was more stable than Windows. That was the only time I did that. Ever since then, it's just because I like it. It's for fun. It's a fun system to run for me. And I know, oh my god, how dare you say Linux is fun and interesting and blah, Linux is serious. I don't use Linux as a job. I sit at home and tinker with it. I don't earn my money by doing Linux things, so why can't I have fun? And that's also why I don't have a problem with people running other operating systems, because that's other ways for them to tinker and explore. Why should you limit yourself to only exploring Linux? Why can't I explore Haiku? Why can't I explore FreeBSD or OpenBSD? Why can't I explore macOS? Or why can't I explore Windows? Why should I limit myself to have fun and explore Linux only? I'm kind of like an operating system agnostic, I think it's called. So I don't know what the fuck you would call it. But I love all operating systems. I really do. Like, I wish more people will make their own operating systems so we could try out. I really, really love running operating systems to see how they handle different problem settings. Like, why do Windows do this thing to handle hardware? Why do Linux do these things to handle hardware? Why do FreeBSD do these things to handle their hardware problems and hardware? That's what's interesting for me. It's not like, this is Linux, this is the only thing I want to run, or this is Windows, this is the only thing I want to run. I love to compare operating system and see, okay, why are they doing it like that? Oh, is this an advantage over, or the way Windows is doing it, is that an advantage over how Linux is doing it, or the other way around? That's what's interesting for me. That's where I love to explore and learn. Linux just gives you more opportunities to explore with different init systems, desktop environment, package managers, package formats. There's just way more things, in my humble opinion, to explore and tinker with in Linux than on Windows, because Windows is this tight-knit closed system, which I do appreciate. I do like Windows. I don't like Microsoft as a company, but as a technology, I do like Windows. I do think Windows is a great technology. There's a lot of great things in Windows, a lot of things Linux can learn from. Just like there's a lot of things in macOS and FreeBSD Linux can learn from. Just like there's a lot of things in Linux everyone else can learn from. We should all learn from each other. So again, why are you using Linux? Let me know down below. I've just talked my ass off about why I'm doing a little bit background into how I got into it. Let me know down below why you like Linux or why you are running Linux. Is it out of necessity? Is it because of work? Is it because X, Y, and Z? And then, as like I said, maybe in the next live stream from when this is uploaded, we can go in and talk about it, and I will look at the comments and see what people are saying, and then I can give you my opinion on or try and decode what they really are saying, because a lot of times when people are saying something, there's something behind it. See you all later. Bye-bye.